tri-state forecast that's independently certified most accurate. Here's Chief Meteorologist Kevin Robinson.
Well, we had a little bit of everything today. We started out the day with gloomy skies and some morning showers. Then those showers made it extra humid as you stepped out around lunchtime. The sun popped out. That strong June sun kind of got the atmosphere bubbling over. And eventually, well, we ended the day with some showers and thunderstorms. A few of them were locally heavy. More so than severe weather they brought to the area, they brought a lot of rain for some folks late this afternoon and into the evening hours. Check this out here on Power of 5 Live Radar. These are some of the rainfall estimates across the area, and when you start getting into some of these yellow shadings, that's in excess of 2 inches of rain. But even across a good chunk of the metro, it went anywhere from about a half an inch to an inch to, in some cases, parts of northeastern Hamilton County up near Sharonville and Blue Ash, between 1.5 to 2 inches. And then farther east, where there were some locally intense thunderstorms, some widespread 1-inch rainfall amount, so a good soaking rain across a good part of the tri-state. So as expected, today was basically the wettest day of the week. Now, that doesn't mean more storms aren't coming back tomorrow, because they are. Let me show you outside right now. Current temperatures are hovering generally in the upper 60s to right around 70 degrees. Here's a look at your headlines for tomorrow. As I mentioned, more showers and thunderstorms are in the picture again across the area. A few of the storms, much like today, could locally be heavy with heavy rainfall and dangerous lightning, of course, being the main threats from any storms. And then by Thursday, I think we are going to start to see some drier weather begin to arrive. Now, that doesn't mean we've completely remove the chance for rain. I just think those storms will be fewer and farther in between as we head into Thursday and certainly into Friday, because by the time we make our way to the weekend, it is looking very nice right now. Looks like another break from the humidity and another break from the daily round of storms across the area. Of course, that won't last long because they'll be back next week. Now, here's Power of 5 Live Radar. It's pretty much quiet around our area. However, the key to the forecast sits out around the St. Louis area, and you can kind of see this counterclockwise spin. Notice how everything's moving from south to north and then towards the west and then back around. Whenever you see that, that's an area of low pressure. And notice, kind of like little spokes on a tire, we had one come through today, wave of showers and thunderstorm activity. There will likely be another tomorrow with the aid of daytime heating, a little sun, so I expect more storms to come back to the area during the daytime tomorrow. 66 right now with a southeasterly breeze at around 7. Most areas are in the upper 60s to right around 70, so most places overnight tonight with the humid air in place won't drop but about another degree or two. So for most of us, it's between about 64 and 68 for a low. Here's the showers and storms that are around earlier this evening. They're lifting out of here. Now, some of the models want to bring in some more rain overnight tonight. I'm a little skeptical to that, but I'm not going to say that it's not entirely possible. I do think a spotty shower or two is possible overnight because of the very moist atmosphere we have in place, and we have that storm center around. But one thing's for sure, it's during the daytime hours, during the afternoon and evening, when storms will be the most widespread, and you can see we'll have them again tomorrow across the region. And then once the sun sets, of course, they will go away once more. So look for a low tonight of around 65, partly cloudy skies. I will keep at least a small thread in there for a shower or a storm. And then tomorrow, certainly keep the umbrella handy. More muggy sunshine will yield to scattered showers and storms during the afternoon and evening. Temperatures up around 80 degrees again. Here's a look at your 7-day forecast, or should I say your forecast, your day planner first. 67 in the morning, climbing into the upper 70s to right around 80. And then there's that 7-day. Notice with less storms Thursday and Friday, temperatures are a little bit warmer. Now, what you will see there Friday night is at 56. That indicates some less humid air to begin the weekend with a sunny and warm Father's Day.
Kevin, thank you for